Hello everyone, my name is Akira Ishii. I'm a master's student from University of Tsukuba in Japan. Today, I would like to share knowledge about this topic. Optical marionette is a manipulation technique of humans' walking direction. In this video, the man asked to walk straight to A panel. However, actually, he is going to B. We control his walking path by our manipulation method. Redirected walking is a manipulation technique of humans' walking direction for VR environment. This uses only visual feedback for the manipulation. This enables users to explore a virtual world that is quite large, quite larger than the real environment. We suspected there are possibilities that humans' walking direction could be manipulated using only visual feedback in the real environment, like a redirected walking in VR. So our goal is to manipulate users' walking direction using only visual feedback in the real environment. To this end, we examined various image processing methods to manipulate walking paths. And we investigated how to manipulate the walking path using the image processing methods. And then we found effective reorienting method using an HMD in the real environment. Let me start implementation in detail. We use a combination of HMD and stereo camera. The camera is attached to the HMD. Users perceive the real world by video provided by an HMD and stereo camera. So we can coordinate users' sight in this setup. We use Oculus Rift DK2 as a HMD and stereo camera and employed Overvision as a stereo camera. This is a video that users actually see using our setup while walking. This is a flow of our method. The camera captures the real world images, and our system applies the specialized image processing to guide to the imaginary direction. So users see processed image by via the HMD. To examine various image processing methods that can affect users' walking path, we investigated effective image processing method in a pilot study. We conducted a pilot study to determine which of the image processing methods have the most effect on a human's walking path. Six image processing methods are investigated. We asked the participants to walk straight 10 meters for each image processing method. We investigated six image processing methods. As a result, changing focal region method was most effective for walker movement control. This is an implementation of changing focal region method. The raw image provided by the camera is cropped, and the HMD displays only the cropped image. When the center position of the cropped area is shifted, the sight of user is also changed. If the center position of cropped area shifted or moved, user feel that they move themselves and they try to correct the movement. Thus, user's walking path is manipulated. In this video, user is asked to go to the B. However, actually, he is going to the A. We conducted an experiment to determine how to control the walking direction using changing focal region method. We asked two participants walk straight 24 meters for each image processing. The image processing methods were no processing, magnification, and changing focal region method. Magnification was added to the image processing methods for comparison because it is used in changing focal region method. This enables us to identify the effect of image magnification and to reveal the pure effect of changing the focal region. In changing focal region method, scroll speed of cropped area in the slow condition was 0.5 pixels per frame. In the fast condition, the scroll speed of the cropped area was twice the scroll speed in the slow condition. We conducted the experiment at two locations to reveal the effect of the environment. The hallway was narrow and had a width of only 2.2 meters. The participants could see several hints for spatial perception, such as walls in the hallway. By contrast, the outside was large and had a width of more than 15 meters. The participants could not find definite hints for spatial perception in the outside. The participants walked straight 24 meters for each of image processing methods at two locations. While the participants were walking, the experimenter manually operated the participants' walking direction. At a point 4 meters from the starting point, the participants were guided to the left by the image processing method. At 14 meters, the participants were guided to the right. In this figure, the blue line is a prediction of the participants' walking path. Result, we analyzed the simulator sequence questionnaire scores with t-test and did not find any significant difference between pre-SSQ and post-SSQ scores. Further, no participants reported feeling any motion sickness. These are users' behavior in the experiment. Under no processing condition, the participants could walk straight naturally. See bottom figure. This figure indicates movement path of all participants. X-axis indicates distance from the starting point, and Y-axis indicates the position of participants. The path for each participant is shown as a gray line, and the path that combines all participants' paths is shown as a red line. By contrast, under change focal region condition, the participants' walking path was strongly affected by this method. So like this. When comparing no processing with changing focal region, the difference of participants' walking path is quite obvious. This is a result at the hallway. We analyzed the participants' walking path with repeated measures ANOVA. As a result, there was a significant effect between no processing and changing focal region, also magnification and changing focal region. We're seeing the figure. Changing focal region affected the participants' walking path strongly. In slow condition, changing focal region changed the participants' walking path by 64.3 millimeters per meter. In other words, if you walk 2 meters, your position moved by 10 centimeters horizontally. In fast condition, this method changed the participants' walking path by 75.3 millimeters per meter. At the outside, the result was same tendency of the hallway. When seeing the figure, changing focal region also affected the participants' walking path strongly at the outside. In slow condition, changing focal region changed participants' walking path by 105.2 millimeters per meter. In fast condition, this method changed participants' walking path by 199.2 millimeters per meter. In the experiment, there was no significant effect between no processing and magnification. This indicates that the cropped image by itself did not affect the participant's walking path. So it is clear that the participant's walking path were affected by movement of the cropped area of changing focal region. We analyzed the position change amount for each imaging processing method with repeated measures ANOVA. As a result, we observed a significant measure effect for the locations. The outside participants were affected more by the manipulation method. The reason for this, in the hallway, the participants could not move more than 1.1 meters because the width of the hallway is only 2.2 meters. Thus, the mean value of the position change in the hallway was smaller than that in the outside. We also observed changing focal region first condition was significantly more effective than the slow condition. The mean value of position change under the first condition in the outside was twice as much as the slow condition. We would like to discuss about our method. Several researchers reported that changing the field of view of an HMD has effect on spatial perception. However, in this study, there was no horizontal spatial perception effect on the experimental result because no significant difference between no processing and magnification. By contrast, we could not determine whether there was any depth perception effect. So we will conduct further experiments to determine this in the future. Conventional navigations require users to recognize information such as go to the light and then follow directions. In contrast, our method directly affects users' bodies so that it can control them without requiring users' recognition processes. Does our method have light burden than conventional navigations? Bruder et al. Showed that a significant amount of cognitive resources is required for redirected walking in VR. Similarly, our method might require some cognitive resources. So we plan to investigate how much cognitive resources are really required by users to follow the manipulation. To determine the feasibility of our method, we demonstrated our method at SIGRA 2016 Emerging Technologies. And over 700 people were successfully manipulated by our method. Like this. Application scenarios. The control method in CISU AR contents, for example, AST tours and museum guides, would be raised as a practical applications. Several people walk around in the limited area and experience the AR contents at the same area at one time. In such situation, true control of humans walking paths is important because users might conflict each other like this. We also think there is possibility of walker navigation system if we can increase the amount of manipulation of users' walking direction. We built prototype or walker navigation system using a method like this video. Lastly, we introduced related work. This research proposed a manipulation technique of humans' walking direction using galvanic vestibular stimulation. This system administers electrical stimulation to the back of ears and controls the walker's sense of balance. This study proposed an EMS-based walker navigation system that controls the walker's legs. These methods use electrical stimulation. By contrast, our method is visual-based manipulation technique of humans' walking direction using only visual feedback. So now, we show the live demo of our manipulation technique. So please come here, Yoichi and Ippei.
think of your identity?
Oh.
Like, wow. So, I control his walking path to the left. So his walking path is my creative method. So that's all. Thank you for listening.
Thank you very much for great talk with the live demo. So we have time for the one or two questions.
Hi, Hiroshi Ishii from MIT Media. It's a very interesting project because it raises some interesting fundamental ontological question. Usually for research, there are two questions. Can we? Second one, should we? So I think manipulate has a lot of strong, also negative connotation from the people manipulate point of view, because so many technology can be also used to deceive something. So could you tell me about the implications of this technology to be used by bad guy, for example?
But us. So I'm reading now. Yes.
So,
is the hacking risk? There is hacking risk. So, please wait for a moment.
Maybe it's not just simple hacking. For example, yes. Autonomous car raises a really important question, when car should take over. So how to really define the boundary? Because people not want to be manipulated always, controls. At certain situation, people have to gain the controls, make a decision on their own. So I think I'm curious about that, because manipulate is something one extreme. But how this technology should be used?
Should be used.
In the context, with some respect to the people, also some meaningful assistance to the people.
I think this is an assistance program. And we use this system while, for example, so there are many people that want to use a smartphone while walking. So Japanese is aruki sumaho. So in this situation, this system is very useful because the user not paying attention to the navigation system. Yes.
Okay, so take one question. Yeah. Short question, please.
Okay, the Higuchi University of Tokyo. Did you test that different size of crop area?
Actually, I did not test another cropped area. The amount of manipulation is depending on the cropped area. So you cropped the small size, the amount of manipulation is larger. But the user's field of view is very narrow. So this is a trade-off between the manipulation amount and the field of view of users.
Thank you. All right. So thank you very much. For